Rick here again. Well, about 3 weeks ago, a buddy of mine and his wife came down for a visit, and we wound up brewing some beer that day. I didn't get any footage of that, but I kind of wanted to maybe show you how to bottle it up and get it ready for consumption. So we brewed about 3 weeks ago, like I said, and it's been sitting in there in the fermenters, and I tested it a couple days ago, and our specific gravity's down to about zero. So I naturally carbonate with cane sugar, so we're going to add some sugar to that. We're going to stir it up, and we're going to put it in bottles here directly. So anyway, I will take you through step by step as we go, and show you more. Thanks. Okay, well, we're going to get started. First of all, you know, you got to have some good music going, so we're going to play some, probably some Greta Van Fleet and who knows what else here while we're bottling. So we got our music going set up here, and this is a siphoning hose, so we'll use that once we get the sugar solution into the beer. And of course, we've got some sanitizer here. All of my bottles are already clean, but I want to sanitize everything. And then we've got some caps, and we've got our bottle capper there, and corn sugar, that's what we're going to use. And then I'm going to do one more specific test with my hydrometer here, and then that's my tube that I use to fill the bottles with. It's got a end on it that automatically, when you lift up, it stops the flow, so hopefully you don't make too big of a mess. And of course, this is our beer in this vat, and right now I've got some sanitizer in this empty one, and we're gonna make sure it's clean, and then we're gonna siphon this into this so we can stir in our sugar mixture. And then I've got 40 pints laying here. I've got 5 gallons of beer. You know, there'll be a little bit of waste because there will be some residue in the bottom of this container when we siphon it over into this one. So, but I've got 40 of them laid out here. We're going to rinse those through some sanitizer. I'm going to kind of show you that. And then they'll wind up over here in the drying rack. And once we get that done, then I will show you how to transfer the beer from one vat to another. So, here we go. This is a no-rinse sanitizer, so just want to get it in there. Up here in the drying rack. what you doing? We wound up with 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 pints. So as you can see, out of 5 gallons, you do lose some to the fallout in the bottom of the container. You don't want to bottle that up. So 25 bottles for the Meets a Pelusa party. See you then.